Today we're going to learn about the fretboard and all the notes on the fretboard. So we're going to learn about what are called natural notes. Those are the notes that only have one name, A, B, C, D, E, F, G. And we're going to learn about the intervals between those notes. So the intervals, an easy way to think about it is I have a term I call buddy notes. So the buddy notes are the notes that are one fret apart, meaning B, C, and E, F, or E, F down here. If you can keep that concept in your mind, and then the fact that every other note in the natural notes is going to be two frets apart or a whole step, then you should be able to find any note on the fretboard anywhere by using that method. I call it, it's like a ladder method, right? Like you're kind of climbing up the ladder. A to B is a whole step. B to C is a half step. C to D is a whole step, and so on like that. So let's run through those intervals. So the intervals are going to be from A to B, it's a whole step. B to C is a half step. C to D is a whole step, D to E is a whole step, E to F is a half step, F to G is a whole step, and then back to A, G to A is a whole step. So when you're looking at that, you'll see the buddy notes are B, C, E, F. So E, F, B, C, B, C, E, F. Now what the exercise is going to be, we're going to start on the E string alone, and we're going to name the notes from E. Say them out loud at the same time. The reason that you want to say these notes out loud is because it's going to cue your memory as far as hearing yourself say it. Also, you want to look at the fretboard so you can visualize it, and you're going to be hearing what that pitch sounds like as well. So you're activating all three different types of memory. So let's go through that on the E string really slowly. Here we go. E, F, G, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, A, B, C. That's as high as we can go on this string, and let's go backwards now. So we're going to go C, B, A, G, F, E, D, C, B, A, G, F, E. Doesn't matter which finger you use, it's more like the exercise is about seeing the notes on the fretboard and where they are. So you want to do that on all the strings. You want to do that on the A string, the D string, G, B, but I'd start with the low E string first. Get that forward and backwards pretty quickly. You should be able to go E, F, G, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, A, B, C, B, A, G, F, E, D, C, B, A, G, F, E. If you can do it that quick, then you're ready to move on to the next string. So get that down, and that's going to help you learn. There's going to be another exercise I'm going to show you eventually to, we'll take some of the notes away, and it'll be easier to memorize separate notes on the fretboard. But let's start with that, learn all the natural notes on the guitar, and then I'll see you for another lesson about learning the guitar next soon. If you like the lesson, don't forget to hit the subscribe button, and don't forget to hit the bell as well, so you are informed every time I put a new video out. And check out my website, uptempomusiclessons.com. I got tons of lessons on there, free lessons. And I also do Skype lessons and can teach you anywhere you are in the world. It doesn't matter. I teach people all over the world. So anyway, thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you soon.